Welcome to Strategies for Science, where we introduce strategies created by Mesquite ISD middle school science teachers in order to maximize time and learning for students. In this episode, one of our science instructional specialists, Mark Wilburn at Vanston Middle School, shows his approach to quick review in a strategy he created and coined, Codewords. Let's find out how Mr. Wilburn uses this strategy to build student capacity and confidence in science.
So a strategy we rely on quite a bit at our school is one called Codewords. We also refer to it as tomato-tomato words, kind of like the old song, you say tomato, I say tomato. We're interchanging, what we're doing is interchanging the vocabulary word with the matching definition. And the definitions that go with these code words are short and simplistic. So anytime a teacher mentions the code word like hurricanes, the class will always know that the next thing the teacher's gonna say is gonna be warm water every time. And it's consistent, it's built into the lesson plan. And the purpose of this is to keep the lessons intentional and grounded and aligned with those really star questions and the teach so that past content doesn't stay in the past and is constantly relevant and brought up in the class period throughout the year. Divergent.
Divide.
Convergent.
Slide.
Gotcha. Convergent.
Collide.
Divergent.
Divide.
Transform.
Slide.
Divergent.
Divide.
Mm-hmm. Convergent.
Collide.
Transform.
Slide.
Convergent.
Collide.
Transform.
Slide.
Divergent.
Divide.
Once we utilize these code words, we'll pretty much quickly go straight to a released question and we'll have the kids practice that. And so what they'll do is they'll identify the word in the question, they'll cover up the answer, and then they will find the matching code word that they know is associated with that. And once they do that right in the middle of a lecture, right after you've taught that new code word, the level of confidence is boosted in that kid and they already can say, wow, I can do this. This is actually pretty easy. So let's go back and let's do this guy, okay? First thing we do when we roll up on a question, what do?
Cover up the answers.
Cover up the answers. Boom, she got you. You gotta be quick, she's quick. Okay, cover up the answer choices. When I cover up the answer choices, I can read here. I see thunderstorms and hurricanes. When I see hurricanes, what do
warm
I think?
Warm water.
There we go. All right, we're even. Warm water. Okay, so I'm gonna write warm water out to the side. What if it said warm water? It didn't say hurricanes. What if it said warm water?
Hurricane.
Hurricanes, every time. Okay, so now I uncover my answers and you've already predicted the answer. Every time we see hurricanes, we think warm water. Fantastic, there it is, the warm water. Okay, there's gonna be all kinds of questions that I could show you where it's hurricanes, warm water, every time. But every now and then they get tricky. I feel like you guys have got the hurricane warm water down, so now we'll add that third code word, okay? Where's the warmest water on the earth?
Equator.
So now I could say hurricane, I could say warm water, I could also say?
Equator.
Okay, awesome. And so when you get with your team and you're analyzing these questions and finding these trends, don't get bogged down by the one question that pops out that has a new word. If it's not something that's kind of every year or you're seeing trending, then don't get bogged down by that. Find those words that are simplistic, and you're seeing them consistently over the course of various years. One of my favorite things about this is that once you've owned these words and you've made it clear to your students that you've gone out of your way to find these words and analyze these questions, become a code breaker for them, they trust in you as the teacher and they're more invested in the lessons and they're more engaged, especially when they see the successes in themselves from the code words that you've instilled in them. I mean, everybody, it's not a new concept, code words. It's just vocabulary matching with a simple definition. The meat behind all of this is that we're consistently doing it each week and we're bringing up those words from, you know, units that were taught weeks ago every week in those warm-ups and those exit tickets throughout class and in the random challenges that we do. But when you can get quick like that, boom, 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 these get pretty easy for the most part. There's a lot of questions that you're gonna see that are like that. Now, some involve you to do some more math and some more thinking. They're not always gonna be like that. But if you know your code words, when you see them, your brain will automatically go, oh. And then what do you know? The answer's there. And I promise you, my job is to look through all these questions right here, day and night. That's what I do, so that when you go into these tests, you can go, oh yeah. That way, you don't have to talk about tests all the time in class, and we can do more labs, more fun stuff, more engaging stuff. You can just trust me that I've got the rest taken care of if you just listen and learn these words. Cool? All right, awesome. Good job. Boom. Got it. Boom. Done.
We would love to see you trying out the code word strategy in your classroom. Tweet what you're doing in class and be sure to use hashtag Mesquite ISD Science so that we can learn from each other. Thanks for watching.